Andre, what kind of security threats do these small and medium businesses like Searchbug experience? And perhaps why do you think these small businesses are being targeted?
It's a good question. I think most people think of, when people think about cybersecurity, they think about like banks or government organizations or big companies. And small companies, you would think, don't have like big secrets to steal from, or even if you put a ransomware, they wouldn't pay much. Where is the catch? So why are they coming for? Like from my perspective, there are two primary reasons. One is to steal credit cards and passwords. So that can be used, say you steal credit card on one side, and then you can use the same card to sell it on a black market somewhere else. And people, you often use the same password on many different sites. So they may not be interested in this particular customer information on your site, but they will try to log into like Amazon or airline website or somewhere else to make purchases with a stolen card and a stolen password. And why this particular theft happens is that small business typically don't have enough resources or even focus or thinking of security. And so they will outsource website development to some junior programmer or some offshore team, focusing on functional requirements, making sure that it looks good, it does what it's supposed to do, but they don't pay much attention to security and protection, and they would leave passwords or credit cards in the plain text. So if someone gets access to your database or hacking in another way, so all information is gone. And the other thing we're noticing is, at least for us, is theft of service is a major issue. So if your business is providing some valuable service information, you will be a target. So like, as I mentioned before, we have information that's any business would want, like we are allowed to append phone numbers to a list of customers who have names and addresses. We can get you emails, or we can get you phone numbers. We can tell if those phone numbers like belong to cell phone or not, or if they are active. So we have background checks, and we have all kind of useful information, and people trying to get it for free. And how do they do that? Back to credit card fraud. I know it's not necessarily falls under cybersecurity, but for us, it's the same problem dealing with unauthorized access to our systems in order to steal the data. So with a stolen credit card. So what happens with this is why it's important, because you're not only going to lose your revenue because you're not going to get paid, you're going to get tons of chargebacks, and it will end up mount your processor fees and you can credit card fees, and you can even be banned by a processor. 15 years ago, PayPal called us one day and say, because of the high chargeback rates, your business account has been closed and you can no longer accept credit cards. And there was no like advance notice, we could negotiate. And all of a sudden, because of the high chargebacks, we were out of business, couldn't collect any revenue until we built a new integration with another provider. And I will talk about this later. SQL injection or SQL injections is most common way how hackers get access to your website. So basically what they do, they manipulate query strings, or they put something in the forms, and they do it in an automated way to trick your database that you're not only searching for customer order, but also show me additional information, how your database is structured. And so once they find what database you're using, what the table structure works, then they try to manipulate it through the same, your website. They don't necessarily log into your server, and they try to get to admin and support accounts. They try to run the services for free. So this is very, very common. And obviously password guessing, tampering with the password resets, that's sometimes a tricky feature. So, and they can create a partial account, go try to reset password and get in. We've seen it all. And also, if you just a quick, if you have a development server or a test server, protect it as if it was a production server, because you have unfinished code. And hackers can take advantage of your lower level vulnerability on your development servers that may have the same sensitive data. So that's kind of like what I see in trenches.